design of liver. Liver is a straight or curved member used to support or lift load with less effort. Lift more load with less effort gives us another definition of one parameter, that is known as mechanical advantage. So these are the examples of two different levers, a special kind of lever where this fulcrum is in between the force and the load, and mechanical advantage is the ratio of load and effort. So whenever we are designing a lever or identifying different dimension of the lever, our aim is to have more and more mechanical advantage. So diametrical diagrammatical view of this lever, we can model this lever with this configuration where we have three major parameters: load, effort and fulcrum. In this case, fulcrum is between load and effort, and we can see that this fulcrum pin we have to provide to arrange to fasten this lever with support and all. So here the cross section is solid, but here at this section the cross section of lever will not be a solid. We have to provide one hole for this. The design of lever includes the cross section of the lever for safe stresses and the design of pin. So there are in general three pin can be there in lever, where one is at fulcrum, another is at load, and one at effort. But there can be even one pin or so. So whenever we are designing a lever, we have to identify or recommend a safe cross section of the lever with the safe dimensions of pin as well. So to design pin and the lever cross section, we have to identify what is the load on the pin and what is the load on the lever. So from this figure it is clear that the lever is subjected to transverse load like this, and this pin is subjected to load. In this case, W is directly transferred to this pin. In this case, load F is directly transferred to this pin. But if we want to find out the load on this pin C, then in that case we have to find out the reaction at point C, and then the resultant of that reaction will be the load acting on the pin. The direction of resultant may be any. In this particular case there will be only one reaction in vertical direction. If there is in some cases there may be x component as well, so resultant may be in this direction. So this resultant we have to find out to design a pin. So first we have to identify the unknown forces and the reactions at fulcrum pin. So this can be done with the help of free body diagram. So we have drawn this free body diagram, we have replaced this pin with two reactions, and now we can apply the equations of static equilibrium for plane. So in plane we have three equations of static equilibrium. So this particular lever is under static equilibrium under the action of these forces. So now we can make use of the static equilibrium. Summation fx is equal to 0 will give us cx is 0. Summation fy is 0 will give us cy as f plus w. And summation of moment of all the forces about point C is equal to 0 will give us this equation. And from this equation we can find out the ratio of load to effort is LB by A. It means mechanical advantage is LB by A. This is equal to 0, greater than 1 only if LB is greater than 1. So whenever we are designing such type of lever where fulcrum is in between load and effort, we want that the effort side is longer than the load side, so that mechanical advantage is more than one. So the bending moment diagram is required to design lever, because lever is subjected to transverse load, and in transverse load the design transverse load we bending stresses are induced, and maximum bending stresses depends on the maximum bending moment. So that is why bending moment diagram here in this case for this particular type of loading is this. So now we can use this general equation, maximum induced stress is equal to design stress, for both pin and lever to design lever and pin. That we'll be discussing later on. The another configuration of lever is like this, where the fulcrum is at one end, here in this case, here in this case, here in this case, and load is between upward and the fulcrum. So in this case we can calculate reactions like this simple formula. Again, same free body diagram using equations of static equilibrium, and then we can draw free bending moment diagram for calculating maximum bending moment that will be used for designing lever section. So here the fulcrum reactions will be used to design fulcrum pin. This maximum bending moment will be used to design the lever section. The other kind of lever where the effort is in between the load and the fulcrum, we can again analyze this force analysis for calculating fulcrum reactions like this, and maximum bending moment will be given by this expression. Now about the material of the lever. Lever can be forged or cast. So in we can use 0.3 to 0.4% carbon steel for forged lever. For complicated sections we go for casting. We can use cast steel or aluminium for this, and severe loading condition we can go for alloy steel. And then the heat treatment improves the hardness and shock resistance. So this is the post you can say manufacturing operation. Then we can go for heat treatment for better hardness and wear resistance. Factor of safety is taken between 2 to 3 on yielding criteria for some complicated or some very peculiar applications. We can even have more factor of safety. In case of fatigue loading, designed for static load, we can go for higher factor of safety. We are designing using fatigue equations, then certainly the lower factor of safety can be done and can be used as suggested by fatigue loading equations. So lever section can be rectangular, it can be elliptical, it can be I section. So generally used sections are these three: rectangular section, elliptical section, and I section. The general design consideration that lever should not be more than 100 mm to avoid dynamic instability, but otherwise the lever length of lever depends on whether it is hand lever or foot lever, whether it is to be operated by single hand, by single person, or it is to be operated by double hand, single one person, or two persons. So that all you can say we have to make use of the dimensions of hand and all that to ultimately set the length of the lever. It should be able to accommodate pin and fork. Certainly the shape, the space and shape for comfortable operation. If we are using single hand, then the shape at that handle should be comfortable for one single hand. Otherwise depends on the type of you can say application. And overload factor is essential for manually operated lever. This we have discussed number of time. Wherever manual operations are there, we have to take, we have to use overload factor, because in that case manual operation is not, you can say, fix, does not fix the amount of load that is applied. So a single hand operated lever can be used by two persons with, or can be sometime used by foot or so. So that is why overload factor is essential. This may be of the order of 2 to 5 even in some cases. So this ergonomic data for loading by a single person in different cases and three different categories: continuous, intermittent and instantaneous, hand operation and foot operation. These are given in Newton. So these data we have to use for designing lever. And we have a guideline for selecting this cross section. If it is 100 to 200 mm square, we can go for rectangular section. If it is 150 to 500 mm square, we can go for elliptic section. Otherwise, for heavier section, it is we can go for I sections. But these are simply guidelines. It depends on application to application, designer to designer, whether we follow these conditions or not. So lever section at fulcrum pin, because as we have discussed, lever is solid between this to this, between this to this, but at this particular section and these two sections, we have to provide hole for pin. But here the bending moment is zero, so that is why it doesn't make much difference. But here the bending moment is maximum, and when we remove some material, it reduces its load carrying capacity, increases the bending stresses. So we have to take care of all these things. So lever section at C without pinhole, when we are not having any pinhole, this could be and this value is nothing but it is the required, this is what we required on the basis of our design equation. And when we have this pin hole there, then it is like this, but this value will be certainly less than this value. So we have to increase this. We can increase this by increasing height of the lever at pin section, or we can provide both like this. So we have two options for accommodating the pin and increasing the section modulus or the strength of this lever, the load carrying capacity of the lever at pin section, by these two. And these two depends on the design of pin that we'll be discussing later on when we are going to use this particular type of modification and when we are going to use this type of modification. And the attachment at pin is like this in both these two cases. This is for this case, and this figure, the arrangement at lever section, is for this modification. Now the value of Z for the modified section is given by this. We can divide this section in three different sections as this. This is section 1, so this value BH square corresponds to this section. This value collectively is for this pink section. And now we have used the expressions for solid sections, so now we have to remove this particular section that is highlighted now. So this we have to remove. Again, this DH is the diameter of hole, and if we can see from this figure, the diameter of pin is this diameter of pin is this one, and we have to accommodate bush over the pin. So that is why the diameter of hole is DP plus twice bush thickness. This bush thickness can be 2 mm to 3 mm bush is provided here in the lever. So it is press fitted in the lever and is freely in between this this interference fit between this lever and the bush, and clearance fit between pin and the bush. So now let us see how the pin is to be designed. So pin design depends on how the pin is loaded. So we have two different assumptions for loading of pin. We can assume that this load F is uniformly distributed, and this F by 2 and F by 2 is also uniformly distributed. we are assuming that LP is the length of pin in the lever. So this is LP, here it is LP by 2, LP by 2. So we are having LP, 2 LP from this to this. So LP we are using, length of pin in the lever. So accordingly we are we can show the loading like this. And in load case 2, if bending takes place, that will be there. And if we consider bending phenomena as elastic deformation, in that case this contact at this particular point and this particular point will be released, and that is why the load will not be there. So we can assume that load is varying from here to here, like this triangular loading is there. So F by 2 will be acting one third of this distance from this point, or two third of this base of the triangle from point E. So this gives us the loading. Now we can find out the bending moment diagram. This is bending moment diagram in this case, and maximum bending moment, this is at point C, it's wrongly written point B. So this is bending moment at point C, FP F by 2 multiplied by LP by 4. So this is at point B, this is at point C. So and the value in this case at point C is directly written, so this 5 LP by 24. So this is we can make use of the design equations to find out other Z required or force that is there. So we generally design a pin, because this is bending mode of failure, we are considering bending mode of failure. There are other modes of failure as well for pin. So in case of bearing mode of failure, because there is relative movement between pin and the lever or bush, so the bearing will also be there, and the contact is not a surface, it is cylindrical contact, and because of the relative movement, so we will be using bearing pressure instead of crushing stress. So the equation, design equation will be changed to this, that is the induced stress, this is equal to bearing pressure. We have induced stress, that is load divided by projected area, because of the circular contact between two surfaces, and this sigma DC is replaced by PB because of the relative movement between pin and the bush or lever. So if we design, we generally go for designing a pin which is equally strong in bending and bearing. We can have the load carrying capacity in the first load case on the basis of bending mode of failure. This is the load carrying capacity in case of bearing mode of failure. If we equate these two, assuming that pin is solid, so that is why Z is pi by 32 dp cube, and we equate these two, we get this relation that can be used directly to design a pin which is equally strong in bending and bearing. For load case 2, this ratio of LP to DP is 0.686, and then design stress over PB under root. So these two relations we can directly use for designing pin which is equally strong in bending and bearing. The last one is shearing mode of failure. So this is shearing mode of failure if pin will fail in double shear. But the shearing stress is induced in pin is very very less, so if we do not check in shearing mode, it's fine. But this is true only if the pin is solid, but if pin is hollow, in that case the shearing stress will be slightly more, so it is necessary in that case to check pin in that mode of failure. So now once the length of pin is obtained using the previous expression, that is LP by DP and the bearing mode of failure, we can get value of LP and DP. So now on the basis of LP and DP, we have to check how the section at pin of lever is to be modified. So if LP is less than B, that is width of lever, in that case we go for increasing h in general, but if lp is greater than b, we go for providing boss, and the modification gives us this type of configuration. So in general, this d boss is taken twice of d hole, and d hole is given by dp, that is diameter of pin, plus 4 to 6 mm to accommodate bush. So it means we know the value of dh, we can calculate d boss, and we can also set l boss that is equal to d boss, or l boss can be taken as 1.5 times of d boss. In between that, we can set any dimension, and once we set this these dimensions, we can now find out what is the actual z, modified z of this particular section, which is at pivot point. And the value of z at this section should be the value of z of a solid section at this point, that is h, initially h and b. So this value, modified section, section modulus of modified section should be more for a pin to be, or for a lever to be safe. So this is how we can design pin and lever section. Thank you for watching this video. If you like, please share.